Samuel Brody Boyd has asked us how to paint the power armour of the Howling Griffons Space Marine chapter. So in this video, we're going to show you how to do that. And this scheme is quite an unusual one because it's actually quartered yellow and red. Now, the easiest way to do this is to start out by base coating the yellow in, which is going to be Avalan Sunset, and then base coating the red, which will be Mephiston Red. After that, we'll shade both these colours at the same time with Agrax Earthshade, and then we'll highlight the yellow first of all using Uriel Yellow and the red using Evilson Scarlet. But we're going to be starting out with Avalan Sunset, and this I'm going to be applying using my medium base brush. And the best way to do these more complex schemes is to actually not worry about being neat in the first step. Just make sure you base coat in one of the quartered colours. So we're starting with the yellow bits here, and you're looking for about that sort of consistency before you begin. And what you want to do is paint, if we're looking straight up the space marine, we're looking at painting the top left and bottom right of this miniature. So what you want to do is apply a space colour over those parts, not worrying about the line where it's going to go to the red at this stage, just making sure we get an even finish to the colour. So you will need to apply two thin coats. Once you've got that even yellow, you're ready to base coat in all the red parts using Mephiston Red. Now start with a medium layer brush and begin by getting that straight line between the two colours. You want to be as neat as you can as you're doing this, and once you have got that line running all the way down on either side, what you need to do is just base coat in the rest of the red using a medium base brush this time. Now that we've established those two base colours, we're ready to shade them. And for this, we want Agrax Earthshade, and we're going to do the recess shade with this. So you want to apply with a small layer brush as neatly as you can. After you've done this, neaten up any splodges before you continue. Once that shade's completely dry, we're now ready to start highlighting. So beginning with Uriel Yellow, highlight all the yellow armour panels with an edge highlight being as neat as you can. And then edge highlight all the red segments using Evilson Scarlet. Now remember, you're only looking for the edges of the armour here. You don't actually need to edge highlight along the area where the red meets the yellow. Don't worry about those parts. Just go for the armour edges. And here we have the completed Howling Griffons power armour, ready for all the remaining details like the gun, the gold, all those kind of things. So Samuel, I really hope that helps you out, and we'll see you all again soon.